I challenge you.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Diddy Kong Racing. I've been into this before. Unfortunately, when I bid at the game, he wants to challenge me to the hovercraft race, so I'm gonna have to do that right now.
Abracadabra!
Shut up. The same sort of idea with the car, except for I basically have to go around 3 times around the entire map of the open world. And it's pretty much some sort of thing, and I mean, what can you say about it? It's just going along your path. It's pretty slow, like, you're beating pretty easily. So, you're not exactly gonna have a lot of bother being. You can beat with anyone in the game, practically. I really have no idea why actually challenges you to race in the first place, whatever. I mean, there is no storyline behind it, why he thinks he can beat you. And you can't really cut across there, because when I was playing this by myself like a year or two ago, I tried to cut across the snow when I was doing this race, and the thing I got pretty much instantly was, you know, you take the wrong path, you fail, sort of thing. It's a bit ridiculous that it even happens, really. I mean, does it even matter what way I go? As long as I beat him in the end, it shouldn't really matter. I mean, this race isn't exactly long or anything, it's just kind of tedious. Let's take it as a minute so far. A minute 30 seconds, get a minute 30 just to beat this one race. We almost half-lapped him, which really isn't that impressive at all. I mean, I don't think you really can lap him.
Hello, friend.
Take us this reward, obviously.
Bye-bye for now.
So he'll give us another reward. What the heck? Do I really have to jump for that? Oh my god, if I can do. I can't get the balloon. That's fantastic. I can't get my prize. Why didn't I just hand it to me? There we go. Right now I'm on a transform.
Hello, friend.
Select
your vehicle. Can I help you further? Bye-bye
yes.
For now.
Go away. How about that? Thank you. So now I need to go and head over to the second area of the game, which is over here. And first of all, we'll be doing Everfrost Peak, which is the only door with number 2 on it, which is the amount of points we needed to get in here in the first place.
Everfrost Peak!
These snow races are actually pretty easy in a way. Like, in some senses, they're a bit easier than actually doing a lot of the dino races, like, you know, the dinosaur, the main races. Just because they're more straightforward, like, there's no hidden areas where they really keep it keen, you know, like, in some sense, there is in Snowball Valley, but obviously, but on these ones, you would never really think, like, in your first time through, to actually look around, because there is no, like, upper path, sort of. It's just a straight path, as far as the hidden area, from what you can see, anyway. I mean, it's pretty much just like the dinosaur, the main races. It's pretty easy to win this, and it's just ridiculous how simple it is. Sort of just duck down and get a 7% on the ground as well as the ones in here. I really don't know if you can actually get that one back there. I think you can, it's just that it's a lot harder than what it actually seems to be. A lot of these levels, you can tell, they weren't really designed for a car at all, sort of thing. But you can use hovercrafts in these sort of levels and stuff. I'm not actually sure if this one lets you use the car on it when you're playing multiplayer, but I know I should use a hovercraft. I'm near enough all of these maps to my use of hovercraft. And I crashed. Okay, right, so I beat that one. And now I'm gonna have to go through here. tick to my left, where there's a free bullet door. The Walrus Cove. So I'm just gonna try and... No, I can't skip it now. Get my quick boost up to start and try and aim for that bullet point. There we go. Myself up here quickly. Walrus Cove is one of my favorite levels in the entire game. Probably one of the most fun, generally because of the fact that it's actually really quick. Like, I only spent about, I don't know, I'd say about half a minute really, so far. Even though it's definitely half a minute. But, in the end, it could actually take you, like, 30 seconds to get around the entire lap. However, it took me 40 near enough to get around. I mean, I'm nowhere near lapping anymore. Still really quick from that. I forgot to really explain what the bananas do. They give you like a better acceleration rate sort of thing, so you can actually get more speed. But generally, with more bananas you pick up, it becomes harder to actually control your car. The faster you go, the less control you've got over yourself. That makes any sense at all. It's kind of like real life driving. I wish it was most easy in real life to actually drive. Just hold a button and go, rather than having to put your foot on the pedal and actually bang 24/7. And when you crash, all you do is say ow, and that's it, your car's fine. Shame it's not like that in real life. And there we go, we won that race. Well, Valley's a bit quicker, I think, actually. However, it doesn't even matter because we got another balloon. Not that that guy should ever really care. Snowball Valley, number 6, on the balloon doors. So, we needed 6 balloons to actually get in here. So, all those balloons might have picked up outside and gotten them, so the main would have helped. Because if we came in here with 2 balloons, we would have been able to beat the rest of the races. Actually, we need to pick up the balloons outside of Dinosaur's Command and stuff to progress later on in the game too, so it's good that I did that early on, as soon as I started pretty much. Oops. I'm actually just trying to get a quick lap on these guys, because if I do that, then I can get the hidden key at the same time that I'm racing. Okay, have enough time right now to get it. Okay, now I gotta beat these guys. I really don't care about my race time, I just gotta beat them. Damn those guys, they're still my boy. Now if I don't screw up here, I will definitely win. There we go. I won with the key. So that was pretty easy. If you can get a key and like when you're racing, that's good. But if not, you can just come back in and get a key and hit start and, you know, return to the lobby. So that unlocks that door back here for Icy Hermit, which is another mini game for a piece of TDM. Frosty Village.
Frosty Village.
This is actually one of my other favorite levels in the game. Pretty much this domain is overall my favorite domain in the entire game. I think it's because, you know, I was young, I was a kid, it was around Christmas time that I used to play this game a lot, like as when I started playing it over the weekend sort of thing. This was actually the first N64 game I got, because ever since N64, when we originally got it, it came packed with Mario Kart, and Diddy Kong Racing. However, my dad went back to the store that day, returned Mario Kart, and got Mario 64, which overall, you know, is a good game package to really have instead of Mario Kart 64. I mean, Mario 64 is basically one of the games that you just must have if you want to have 64. However, a lot of them came packed from Mario 64. I really don't understand how the hell we managed to get Mario Kart instead. Maybe the quirk in the store, he messed up or something. Right, I thought it was like 5 or 6 of the things, so I don't even remember how the hell we got Mario Kart over Mario 64. But it's not like I really complained about it. Because in fact, I basically wanted the Nintendo 64. My cousins had one. I played it at theirs, and like I just wanted the Nintendo 64 from that point on. My parents got me one. I really didn't care what games were on it. I just wanted to be able to play games. Well, that was strange. I think I may have glitched it because it was coming a bit too fast. But I just generally had no idea like what games I would get, and so it wasn't like upset about it. And there we go. Yeah, shut up. So, this opens up the box store for us, and it's just gonna be an absolute pain, but I'm gonna do it in the next video. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you later when we take on the Walrus, which is the box that is the main. Thanks, anyway.